If you type in here localhost and Drupal, and if you don't see this page coming up, what you have to do is go to your start menu, all applications, go under Bitnami, that is Bitnami Drupal Stack Manager. Click on that. This is what it comes up, and this is what the Bitnami Drupal Stack look like. So make sure the server managers are running. These should be running, then only you can see the web pages. If one of these running, you can't see it. Say for example, let us stop that. So both of them stopped, and let's reload this page. You see, oh sorry, page is not available. That's what happened. So you have to be starting all of them. So when it all starts and reload the page, it comes. So we'll be using this a lot in the Drupal course. So what you have to do is you can actually keep this in the taskbar. So go to all pages, all start page, under Drupal stack, right click on the Drupal stack manager and pin to taskbar. So you can access it all the time, this one. And if you're not using your Drupal, you can always stop it, stop all, to save resources. Let's look at where the files are located. It's in Explorer. We put it on Documents, Bitnami, under Apps, Drupal, htdocs. This is the Drupal files. It's quite a number of clicks and it's very hard to get into. So there is an easy way to access this file. Go to the Libraries, right click, create a new library, and let's call it Bitnami Drupal 8. Enter, double click on it, and include a folder. And so make sure the folder you are is the Drupal folder, htdocs, as apps, Drupal, htdocs. As you see htdocs, that's what you want. Include the folder. So you go to the file, libraries, there is Drupal code in here. Or you can even bring it, you can move it from, have a shortcut, pin to File Explorer. Just leave it and it goes into File Explorer, see Bitnami Drupal 8. So you can access this way. This right click on that and Drupal 8. It goes the same place. That's another easy way. Let's have another look at the Drupal Stack Manager. So if you want to see a Drupal application, that means the Drupal site, click on that. It will go to the Drupal site, localhost, access that. That's the Drupal site. All the Drupal site information is kept in the database. To access the database, you open PHP MyAdmin. For the initial access, it is the username is root, and my password is, I just put password for the test purpose. So go that. So that is our Drupal site database here, Bitnami Drupal 8. You click on that, you can see all the tables related to that particular site. Even though it is a blank site, you can see a lot of structures in place. If you click on here, it will take the folder where you kept all the source code, and you can visit Bitnami to look at more support and so on. You can get support there. If you need more information, read about it in the Bitnami wiki page. All of them is accessible from this site. And manage servers. Now, if you have any trouble, this site is not running, make sure these are running. Quite often it is one of them running, one of them stopped or something. So stop them all and restart it. And often, if even in that it didn't work, you can restart the computer, and sometime it will clear things up. Drupal 8 is actually much easier than Drupal 7. The important modules already loaded in into the Drupalite, and it makes it much easier, so it's all working much more smoothly than before. In the next movie, we will log into Drupal site and start creating content. Thank you.